My second work concerns the study of the asymmetry of the heart rhythm in various conditions of the heart, namely the study of the asymmetry of the speed spot plots in a four quadrant representation for atrial fibrillation arrhythmias. As you know, the analysis of heart rate often comes down to the study of its variability. There is sufficient number of works that reveal the effect of the heart rate of the sympathetic or parasympathetic branches of the nervous system. One of the graphical methods for studying heart rate variability is the method of scatterography or this, or the study of Poincaré spots, of Poincaré plots. We proposed a method that we call speed spot and which allow not only the heart rate value to be displayed on the graph, but also the rate of its change. Slide two shows a comparison of Poincaré plot and speed spot. So Poincaré plot, as you know, is a chart in which each RR interval is plotted as a function of the previous RR interval, where the values of each pair of consecutive RR intervals are plotted on the point of the graph. This is the left side of this presentation. The essence of the speed spots visualization method is that the coordinate of the state point in the orthogonal coordinate plane is formed as the current value of the RR interval, this is x coordinate, and the value of the rate of change in the duration or RR intervals near the current value of RR. DRR, it's this is a y coordinate. Clouds formed by the set of such points, both in Poincaré plots and the proposed method, are characterized by SD1 and SD2 descriptors, calculated as the length of the ellipse axis. That unrolled this cloud. Moreover, maybe additional descriptor is D12 that as the ratio of the first two. As can be seen from this expression for the speed spot, these descriptors are calculated as the standard deviation of correspondent variable. Slide three shows images of three of spots for two states, normal rhythm and atrial fibrillation state. You can see a significant change in the graph and accordingly, the main descriptors that characterize them. The same can be observed in the graph of behavior or descriptors over time. It should be noted that is during the atrial fibrillation process, the Poincaré plot significantly changes its shape and takes the triangle form, like this triangle form, or the form of comet. Then the speed spot likely retains ellipsoidal shape, changing only in size. The early studies of the asymmetry of the speed spots by our team showed that as well as for the Poincaré spots, they are characterized by an imbalance of acceleration and deceleration process. In this case, the coefficients of degree of imbalance for speed spots are the ratio of the variance of array of points with positive values of velocity and with negative values of velocity to the total variance respectively. In addition, the overall coefficient asymmetry was determined as the ratio of the above two values. You can see plots in time, this variable of speed spot asymmetry. Closer look at this coefficient during an atrial fibrillation attack showed sharp surge only at the end of the attack. See on it. This factor can be used as a marker for the presence of an atrial fibrillation event in a patient. In addition, this explains the physician's statistics that characterize the moment of the end of atrial fibrillation as the most likely moment of the onset of a stroke. To analyze the symmetry of the speed spots in the four quadrant interpretation, the data were normalized first. The idea of the normalization was to center the speed spot relative to the origin. For this, the average value of corresponding variable, rhythm of its speed, was subtracted from the obtained data. This presentation made it possible to formally assess the nature of the asymmetry in the following four types. Q1, rhythm is greater than average and the speed is positive. Q2, rhythm is greater than average and speed is negative. And Q3, rhythm is less than average and speed is negative. Q4, rhythm is less than average and the speed is positive. Asymmetry was assessed by the number of points in each of the quadrants for normal and atrial fibrillation conditions for an array of successive windows of 300 values. The results of this calculation, of this analysis, are shown in slide 6. This is time graph episodes of before atrial fibrillation. Atrial fibrillation case is after atrial fibrillation case. And it's this table show us numerical characteristics of this coefficient. Analysis of this data showed this abnormal rhythm. The distribution of the values of the duration of the RR intervals has a regular gait asymmetry both in absolute value and in the rate of their change. In this case, all the coefficients from Q1 to Q4 rhythmically change their sign. And when atrial fibrillation occurs, there is decrease in the amplitudes of change in the coefficients Q1, Q4, which can be explained by a decrease in the rate of cardiac output and a violation of the cyclicity of waves of acceleration and deceleration. The end of atrial fibrillations is accompanied by a significant divergence of the Q1, Q3, and Q2, Q4 curves. That is, there is significant asymmetry accompanied by a sign change in both the heart rate parameter and the parameter of its rate of change. And the four quadrant speed spot analysis can be used to analyze the degree of arrhythmia of interest for further research in the analysis of asymmetry of speed spot for various types of cardiac abnormalities. Thank you for your attention.
Okay, thank you for your presentation. Questions from the audience? Yes.
Yes, I would like to interfere again. Thank you for your very interesting presentation. And since I was playing a little bit with similar data, in my case was not ECG, it was EEG. My question is about using slightly different primary methods like recurrence plots and Gremian angular fields. Have you tried this to your data? Because it can lead to quite interesting results. This is just an opinion. I did not try it, only on EEG in my case.
Thank you very much for your question. I think this could be really interesting because we have been focused and on the in English, I didn't know in English, Theoria Hauser,
chaos theory.
Chaos theory. Yeah, it's Kolmogorov equations. It's almost near this theory.
Yes, you're right. But this recurrence and, of course, are connected. Recurrence plots and angular fields are connected, but it's not about Kolmogorov. It's something else. I'm just wondering if you tried, just as a suggestion, you might find something interesting.
Thank you for your suggest. I'll try to use this and found out. I think I found out many new items in this. Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay.